another expansion at the 6 o'clock to take a solid economic lead, and he's just been brutal with this harassment. And the gas is down. Bisou is putting on a clinic here. Still wailing away at Iris's front door. Iris is not out of this match, but Bisou is definitely in a death grip as far as the lead. Two Dragoons still sitting in that back corner, and that was some beautiful harassment. And yeah, I think that was definitely the best choice. Put Iris on the defensive early. Don't let him get in your head, get in his head. Both these guys master harassment, I would say. And yeah, now only one gas to work off of, and I know Iris wants that second gas. Now he's going to plop it down. Still working off a single factory. It looks like he lost his barracks on the front door to those Dragoons that were attacking the front. And Bisou, actually, I think he's got this game, because all he has to do is get a decent amount of probe saturation at that 6 o'clock location, throw down a whole bunch of gateways, and he's going to be able to run over Iris in not too long. Iris is not going to be able to defend. Basically, Bisou can just play the safe game, play the economic edge. Actually, if he wants to, continue ferrying troops down there, do some more zealot bombs, get zealot speed. Yeah, he's in a great position. Now, Wraith running up to try to see what he can. Looks like he's only got 4 kills to his name. He'll at least be able to see the gateways building. He might be able to sweep across the south to see the additional expansions being planted. That siege tank still... Yeah, the siege tank's not even on the front. They're so worried about that attack from behind. Observatory being planted as well. Very late observatory, but he's not really needed it because there haven't been any vultures out there. That's been the key, actually, I would say, for Iris's defeat. It looks like Iris getting at least 2 hits on that shuttle as it's pulling away. Iris just did not have spider mines, and he didn't have any vultures on the field. It was just going straight tank heavy, and it really cost him. Those spider mines would have been the difference in a lot of those battles. He wouldn't have had that would have been essentially kind of that hidden latent defense in that back edge. Bisou wouldn't have had free reign of his base. Instead, Bisou now up 3 bases to 2 in a strong economic edge, plus the probe saturation is much better than the SCV saturation comparatively. But now it looks like a dropship produced from Iris. Iris realizing he's got to do something creative to get back in this game. A Reaver switching around. I don't think the shuttle saw that Reaver coming. A Dragoon bomb, and looks like they're... Reaver does manage to get 2 SCV kills. Bisou doing a fantastic job. The 2 Dragoons that were hidden in the back, wandering up, trying to take out that Wraith. It doesn't... Oh! Simultaneous kill, which is an advantage for Iris. Dragoons already in. Looks like Iris... Almost able to pull the mine. Nice little hop-up there by Iris. Able to get that tank right back in the shuttle. It looks like he's going to be able to get some probe kills of his own. And he's got to do some of this to get back in this match. Another attack here. Let's see if that siege tank is just going to take one last kind of the fatalistic blow. It's like, ha, die, Dragoon, that are going for the probe lines. Didn't really accomplish a lot with that. Definitely not as much as he wanted to. Pumping up to 3 factories. And he, actually, Bisou doesn't have a lot of troops out on the ground. He's kind of neglected that at this stage. He's just been powering up his economy. Look at that probe saturation. 2 forges down, so he's going to go for some mass upgrades here as well. Really... If Iris can just pump a lot of troops in it, just for about half a second, he might have an opportunity here. Dragoon's running up. Going to be able to pick this. Oh, able to pick that shuttle off. And I think there were a couple troops in it as well. Everything going right for Bisou right here. And now Iris actually starting to make a maneuver. And this is the danger for Bisou. Got those 3 Dragoons out, but lost that Reaver in the back edge. Was just being a little bit overly aggressive. Was hoping that Iris would just stay back. And let's see if Iris continues to be his aggressive self and just says, screw the additional expansion. I'm just going to take out one of Bisou's bases. I know I'm already economically behind. I know I'm probably... I need to catch up otherwise. And actually considering right here, this is Iris's one opportunity. He needs to go up and do something, I really feel like, in the next minute or a minute and a half. Otherwise, Bisou's just going to have a flood of troops that are going to be bearing down on him. And I take that back, actually. That's... Okay, never mind. He does have the 6 gateways. The 6 gateways versus the 3 factories. And it looks like Iris instead is trying to play a safe game. He's going to try to just take another expansion and catch up over the long-term macro game and play the kind of turtle style. And I think this is a huge mistake. Because, again, as we've seen in the past, Iris... Or I'll say it again, I guess. Iris is a much better player when he's playing aggressive. Much better player when he's playing aggressive. So, and I guess he's trying to do a little bit of that with the shuttle, but it's still not the same thing as kind of throwing those vultures out in the ground and running up with the big attack. He might be able to accomplish a lot with this little vulture force, though. Planting mines right outside these gateways, that's definitely going to hurt production for a while. There's still a cannon back there. Unfortunately for him, Zealots running out, and Zealots absorb mines fairly well. And the Vulture's kind of pinned in a corner. They're not really in a good place to micro against this. So not getting a lot of pro kills. Okay, looks like he's going to be able to wander up, disrupt mining a little bit. But otherwise, not in that fantastic position. I also don't think Iris has actually gotten Academy and Comsat out. There's the Templar Archive, so Visu going to start winding up. I don't think he's going to skip to Arbiter Tech. I think he can actually get High Templar out. I think he's going to stick to a larger ground game this time. Yeah, and it looks like that is, in fact, the case. Armory now being planted for Iris. Don't see the second armory just yet, and now, yeah, he's just going to take his mineral only. And again, I think this is a mistake. I think Bisou's going to have lots of opportunities to take additional... Well, actually, I think he's going to have an opportunity here to just crush Iris's army. Let's see if Iris... If he's going to have some defensive... any sort of defensive prowess here, it needs to be seen here. This is when Iris really needs to summon all of his defensive strength. And it looks like he's going to send out another Vulture Force with the dropship, interestingly enough. So it's going to be a larger Vulture Force kind of ferried up to the top. So going to pull a Bisou on Bisou here, I guess. A little bit of cliffside. Finding a little bit of room to do so. Going to have to back off momentarily. An Observer and three Dragoons actually should be able to press in that without too much trouble. This is creating a lot of breathing room for Iris, though. Now the Vulture's wandering up. I'm not sure what's with this. The Vulture's wandering up, taking a bit of tech. Nice mines, actually, hitting a lot of those Zealots. And they're not individually grouped there, so they're going to actually take a lot more damage than I think Bisou really wanted to. Nothing really. I think Iris might have been thinking the mineral only was being planted at that stage. It looks like Bisou actually has kind of a force. I guess he's hiding it at the 9 o'clock. He's taking the bottom left-hand corner in the meantime. As you can see on the mini-map there, they're showing the expansion out in the field. Just the Vulture. So more dropships out in the field for Iris. And I think Iris is making kind of the mistake we've seen a lot of Terran players made on Outsider, which is, Bisou's not going to make him pay for it. So I take it back. This could work out. As long as Bisou does not go in with the much larger army he has and go for Zealot Bombs and things like that and just kind of run up the front door. And as long as Iris can keep sneaking these troops through, and it looks like he is going to manage to sneak these Vultures all the way around, I'm not sure. There might be siege tanks in there. A single Dragoon starting to wail away at this. Looks like they are going to be able to sneak right over that cannon. This is going to be difficult for Bisou. The problem with doing a blockade like that is now your troops can't... Well, the Zealots can get through, but it's much more difficult. The mine's in the way, actually clearing a lot of the Zealots. The tanks... Zealots can't attack air, so it looks like these tanks going to be able to pull out without too much trouble. So getting a couple probe kills, taking out that cannon, now falling back. And critically, again, this is keeping Bisou from attacking Iris's front door. This is going to give Iris some time to inflict economic damage on Bisou while Bisou's not really doing anything with the economic lead he has. Finding the Arbiter Tribunal and also finding a single cannon there. And he's going to come back, actually, and do a multi-pronged attack, actually. Several tanks at several locations. That Zealot's going to have a hard time against this. I'm kind of curious where the other dropship and the other tank is going. And it looks like it's going to be three tanks here at this location. All sorts of probes getting worked out. Now Iris actually coming right back in this match. So I felt like there was a minute there where Bisou could have pushed in and ended this game. But he just didn't have a good... I don't think he realized how much economic damage he did to Iris. And as a result, yeah, he didn't push it. He was trying to play the longer economic game. He's still up three bases to four, but he's suffered a lot of probe hits now, and I think Iris has actually managed to sneak right back in this. We're back to ground zero, and even, I have no idea who's going to take this match at this stage. I thought, yeah, for a second there, I thought Bisou just had it, and let's see if he gets aggressive now. I think he's playing a little bit more cautiously, waiting for Arbiter Tech, a little bit concerned about Iris's, I guess, counterattack capabilities. Nice little supply depot out in the way. Those Dragoons going to have to back off now. Actually, I take it back. I'm not sure that Iris has bad... I'm going to reverse statements I've said prior. Iris is not as good at defending. He's still decent at defending. I mean, he's a Terran. All Terrans are... I'm going to hold this. Zealots running absolutely no mines in the way. So huge amount of... This is what I expected a couple minutes ago, and that entire front door absolutely collapses. Let's see if Iris has some sort of reinforcements to help come around and defend this. He's definitely going to have to bring whatever troops he had back, but... Dragoons completely free and not a lot of siege tanks to stop them in that back edge. He didn't have a lot of units clumped up, fortunately for him, so that Psy Storm really didn't do all that much. But the Dragoons melting rather quickly, and I'm wondering if that's just, some siege tanks on that south ridge hammering them from above. They do have that level 1 weapons upgrade, but Bisou actually has a decent armor upgrade as well. So just nice spread there, actually, by Iris. So Iris actually putting up some nice defense in that scenario. So I'm actually going to go back on earlier statements. Iris isn't terrible with defense. I just think it's one of the, out of all of his features, and he's doing this trick where he's going to keep those tanks out to the side again, I think. But I think that's one of the weaker points of his game as a whole. However, Bisou is a master of exploiting things like that, and if you do not have a strong defense against Bisou, you are in a lot of trouble. I'm trying to think of strong defensive Terran players. Like Light, I would say, is definitely a very strong defensive player. Hiri, that's all he has, that he's all defense, basically.